Hi, this is Steve Valiquette for Hockey Night Live. Mats Zuccarello this season has been on fire. 20 of his points have either been scored when the Rangers were up by a goal, down by a goal, or tied. Now that speaks to the perseverance of the player, as well as the technical ability of the player. And we're going to look a little closer and to see exactly how he's doing it. At 5'7", Mats Zuccarello has never shied away from the front of the net. But on April 24th, he took a puck to the face from Rangers captain Ryan McDonagh. He skates off to the bench as if it's not a big deal, but this was a very significant injury at this point in this young man's career. Mats Zuccarello had swelling on his brain and was unable to speak for several days. And at points during the recovery, he was unsure if he was ever going to play hockey again. Look, from a team standpoint last year, the Rangers certainly missed Mats Zuccarello during the postseason. But my biggest concern coming into this season for him was he going to be able to skate and become the playmaking winger that he was last season. This is his very first period of hockey this year in exhibition season, and I love it. He comes through the neutral zone with a lot of speed and then carries the puck towards the net on his backhand. He never shows his shot, and he makes this beautiful cross-ice feed across the slot line to Brady Shea for a high percentage scoring chance and a goal. And if that wasn't enough, he scores a goal in this game as well with his quick release and accurate shooting. So he's looked remarkably good from the beginning. Watch this play right here against the Philadelphia Flyers where he starts the puck up the rush off the transition, gets knocked down as he's trying to get to the front of the net, gets back in front of the net, and when the puck goes back to the point, it's on Ryan McDonagh's stick, the same player that injured him 8 months earlier. And Mats Zuccarello is taking position in front of the net, like the warrior that he is, and creating offense for the Rangers. There are very few players in the league at 5'7" that are this determined. Look at how bright this young player is. He sees space between Jake Allen's stick and his pad. He puts the puck right through Jake Allen's triangle, and he hits Brassard on the back door. This is a high percentage play. It's scored once every 3 times it's attempted. To create high-end scoring chances, you've got to be very quick on transition, and the Rangers are just that here. We have Toronto trying to defend this rush. A big triangle presented for Mats Zuccarello again, and he puts this pass straight through to Ryan McDonagh, who was able to convert on the slot line pass. Zuccarello could shoot from out here, but only has about a 3% chance of scoring. When he passes it through the open triangle, he's able to open up that ice and give a gift of a pass to Ryan McDonagh, a high percentage scoring chance that will be scored 30% of the time. Mats Zuccarello has given his teammates 12 slot line passes. This is why I call him the goal distributor. This pass right here is the 4th time he's gone across the slot line in this game alone. But on this pass specifically, look at the positioning of the goaltender, already down on his knees. This is advantage shooter. Zuccarello chooses not to go for the shot, but to give it unselfishly to his teammate Derek Stepan for an open net. These types of goals are where Zuccarello is the most important player on the team, and this speaks to the reason why he is leading the team with primary assists. There's an argument right now in hockey that could be had. Nash, Brassard, and Zuccarello are the best line in hockey. They rival Ben, Sagan, and Sharp in Dallas, as well as Kuznetsov, Ovechkin, and Oshie in Washington. The forechecking ability, the ability to turn over the puck, and then make a high-end opportunity like this one. Zuccarello makes the goaltender honor his shot. That's the most important thing, technically speaking, from a skill set standpoint. And then he passes the puck across to Brassard. That freezes the goaltender, makes him arrive late, and that's why this goal is scored. Again against Winnipeg, same thing, transition game. All three players line up. They add width, depth to the attack. In a triangle formation, Zuccarello gets the puck on the back end of this play and puts it home. Zuccarello has shown this season that he shoots it, so you have to honor him one-on-one. But he's also going to be a guy that's going to shoot it when there's a screen there, as he smartly shoots this puck with Rick Nash and the defender for San Jose screening out Martin Jones. This is a high-end scoring opportunity because Martin Jones, as you can see here, cannot see the release of Zuccarello. Jay Bouwmeester of the St. Louis Blues is one of the best skaters in the NHL. And if you think you're going to have a tight gap on Zuccarello because he's looking for the pass and you want to tighten up on him, well, think again, because now he's a guy that's going to try you one-on-one. And when he gets through you, you're going to have a long skate back to the bench, as Bouwmeester did after this play. He's not a player that's just shooting it for the sake of shooting it. He's putting thought into everything that he's doing. He's honoring the goaltender so that everything has become a high percentage chance to score. Mats Zuccarello is such a story of perseverance. For any young kid, you want to be able to be a player that can fight through all the adversity that you're going to be challenged with in your career. Mats Zuccarello is a great example of that. You saw the injury last year, how he's been able to come back from it. I'm sure he's had his share of challenges during his life, and that's how he's able to get it done now. And in addition to that, the technical ability, the skill ability, his ability to pass the puck. He's been able to do it all during his career with the New York Rangers, and we look forward to watching him this year in the postseason healthy.